we're here at the pay-per-view, because I refuse to say premium live event.
PPV.
This is, what pay-per-view even is? I've forgotten at this point.
Extreme Rules.
Extreme Rules. Okay, cool. Oh yeah, it's in the notes from my Boys and Girls Club book. As you can see from Breezy's aesthetic, now it's nighttime.
The ambiance. You never know when we're filming. We film in the morning, we film in the afternoon, and the nighttime.
It looks creepy because you got that yellow light shining outside your window.
That's right.
Very Freddy Krueger style. Nightmare on Elm Street.
Yeah, that's right. I'm just expecting something back there at some point.
If you could have dinner with any horror movie monster, who would it be?
Ghostface.
Why Ghostface?
I just love it. I love Scream. Oh. Scream is like the first real horror movie I ever saw.
Really?
Yeah.
That's wild.
Yeah.
I saw Chucky when I was like a little kid.
Really? I think I knew about Chucky, but I don't think I'd ever watched it.
Bro, like I was little enough to like be almost as big as a Chucky doll. I was a little bit bigger than a Chucky doll. I shouldn't have seen it.
Why are you watching this?
I have cousins.
You should. Yeah, that's true. It's always the like slightly older cousins. They get you into the movies, the music.
Yeah, bro. And then it was like Chucky. What else? We watched Puppet Master. Do you remember Puppet Master?
Yeah.
Puppet Master was so sick with Pinhead, big old body, little tiny head.
Wait, that's not. Is that that's Hellraiser?
No. So Puppet Master is a dude makes all these puppets that are like demons or something. I don't remember the plot. So Pinhead is they're all puppets, so they're small.
Yeah.
And so Pinhead has like a big jack body, but a tiny little head with a drill on it, so it'll drill you to death.
Weird.
What about Hellraiser? Are you thinking of with
Hellraiser's Pinhead, the guy with all the pins in his head?
Yes. What did I say?
Pinhead.
I said Pinhead.
You said Puppet Master had Pinhead.
What did Puppet Master? What was his name?
It must be a different guy. I don't think it's Pinhead.
It can't be Pinhead, because that's Puppet Master's name. Puppet Master Drill Head. Let's see. Tunneler.
Tunneler.
Who's the drill guy? Drill Sergeant, also known as Retro Tunneler, was originally a rod puppet created by André Toulon in Paris, France, during the early 1900s.
Okay. So Tunneler is the real guy.
Oh, no. His name is Pinhead.
What?
Pinhead's only power is his two big hands that can deliver quite the punch. He's also unnaturally strong and able to move or drag a full-grown human body with ease. So he didn't have a drill on his head. I was thinking something else. He just has a very pointy head. Like he's like a tiny cone head.
Okay, okay, okay.
You gotta watch Puppet Master, dude.
I gotta watch Puppet Master.
It's so sick.
I got it. Funny enough, I've never seen Hellraiser either.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I've never seen it.
Have you ever seen you know Tales from the Crypt?
Yep.
Have you ever watched Tales from the Hood?
No.
Bro.
What?
Bro, what? We gotta watch it.
Is this like a Wizard of Oz and Wiz comparison?
No.
The same but different?
No, the Wiz is just a version of Wizard of the Oz with mainly black people in it.
Sure.
And Tales from the Hood is stories, like horror stories that are like in the hood.
Okay.
So, like, in the sense that there's more black people, yes.
Is there an old crypt keeper?
It's the same crypt keeper.
The same guy?
Yeah, they said the same old, like, bag of bones guy with, like, the scraggly hair and the skeleton. Yeah, it's still him.
Oh, he's in this one, too?
Yeah. It's like Leprechaun. Like, the Leprechaun is in all Leprechaun movies.
Sure.
Even the ones in space and one is Hornswoggle. Yeah, and, you know, they're all Leprechaun movies. Okay. So these are all Tales from the Crypt, but these are just Tales from the Hood.
Tales from the Hood.
Great movie. And if you've seen that, please, please educate all your friends that have not seen it. I'm going to go to Breeze's house and watch it with
them. I've never even heard of it.
What?
I've never even heard of it.
Oh.
Is it a movie or a show? Because
it's a movie.
Tales from the Crypt was a TV show.
Yeah, but this was a movie.
Okay. Interesting.
Oh, it's so good.
Interesting.
Well, I don't know if it's good. I don't know if it's good or if I just like it.
You might just like it. It might be terrible. Realistically, when's the last time you watched it?
You know what? I'll be honest. I don't know if I've ever seen it all the way through.
Wow. So you'll be surprised at actually how many things you probably have like that you have not watched all the way through.
Yeah, like I know certain things from them. Like I know I've seen certain parts.
Yeah.
But I can't tell you for sure that I sat and watched it from intro to credits. But I know specific scenes about certain stories that they have in it.
Okay.
But I can't tell you one movie that I have seen from title to credits many times.
What?
White Chicks.
I knew that one.
It's the best movie of all time.
That also kind of falls in that category of, is it the best movie of all time, or do you just like it?
No, that definitely doesn't. That's objectively the greatest movie ever made.
Bold statement.
And I stand by it.
Wow.
I stand by it. It's a great movie.
Okay.
Yeah. Anything pressing we need to talk about? I feel like we should talk about this.
I feel like we have plenty to talk about during this PPV.
Okay, yeah, so let's get started.
That's right.
Let's get it started. This is your show.
Look at this freaking card, man. Look at this card.
Mm-hmm. Anything you want to say about this match?
No.
All right, I'll hit spectate.
Spectate it up, son. Spectate it up, man. Titles on the line. Finally ending this rivalry that's been going on for months and months and months.
Well, we'll see. We'll see if it ends.
Oh, God, it better.
Maybe the people want more.
But they don't. There's no way. There's absolutely no way that they want
more. You never know.
I don't know.
Logan Paul. Yeah. Music. Yeah.
Why isn't he coming out on his little thing?
What? What little thing?
The little zip line.
Oh, yeah. Well, for this one, they said, let's save it for Saudi.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you know.
Wow, you better skip this entrance, huh?
Oh, well, I thought you had control of it, too.
I don't. This is all you. I'm just spectating.
Come on, man.
We're just spectating. You're in control here. You're in control. Just like you're in control of your life and that new nose ring you got.
I don't see a problem with this.
There's no problem, but you explained to the peeps what happened here. Because last time we were, when we booked this PPV, there was no nose ring.
This is very true, and so I actually turned my head when you said it, so you could see a little bit better.
Oh, we see it gleaming.
Yeah.
Glistening.
You know, in the lights, you know. That's little, right. Little bling, bling.
We see it.
I've wanted to pierce my nose for a really long time because, so when I was younger, and I guess now still, when I realized that I wanted to grow my hair out, I always wanted to afro. But my parents were like, you're not going to take care of it yourself, and we're not taking care of it for you, so no, you can't have it.
Do you know what's really funny?
You wanted one?
I also wanted an afro. My mom had to explain to me that it wasn't possible.
Of course you wanted an afro. And she lied to you. That is possible.
I don't know if it is.
You could perm your hair, right?
But
that's
my
what
hair,
a perm will do for you.
I don't know. So my hair is like super heavy and straight. And like it's got to be curly for an afro, right?
I mean, I feel like if you did the right things, if we can go to Mars, you can have an afro.
I feel like it might be able to be done, but not as easily as you can do it.
Well, of course.
Which also, the afro just seems like an anomaly. I don't know how anyone does it.
An anomaly?
It's just so cool looking. You've seen like the like really big ones?
Of course, I have a really big one.
You can get like the short, tight one, but then you can also get like the ready to rumble afro thunder, dude.
I like how you said you can get. So it's just if your hair gets longer. So like my hair will get crazy huge if I want it to. It's called, you just blow it out. So essentially you take like a blow dryer and you attach a pick to it, and as you pick it out, it just grows and it's huge. But
is that because it's so curly?
Yeah, so was you when you're essentially straightening it, I guess.
Because my hair will just go puffy, but it won't yours will go out. You're saying like yours will go out.
Yeah, but if you got like a perm or did whatever the thing you need to do to your hair is,
yeah,
you could probably, your hair would probably do it.
Maybe they just have
but
to.
But I don't know anything about hair, so
I don't know either. I'm just going off my mom, what she told me when I was like 7.
It's fair. So if I blow my hair out, so I'm not gonna do it too big, because if I do it to as big as it'll go, and I go outside, the wind will blow it and like mess it up, you know. So cool. That's why, like, you might blow it out and then pack it back in so that it is tighter. So you can make it, if you have a lot of hair, you can pack it in, like, as tight as you want and then make that shape. Like, you remember, like, so, like, look at, like, remember when Steve Harvey had hair?
Yeah.
How his hair was perfect no matter what? It looked like he got a haircut every morning when he woke up.
Yeah.
Like, he was, I don't know what he was doing to it, but he was shaping it perfectly, you know? And people in the chat that watched the Steve Harvey show, You know what I mean? It looked like, not, I'm not saying this in a negative way. It was like perfect, like Lego hair. Like he snapped it on. Yeah, like it was
maybe he did get a haircut every day.
I mean, it's quite possible. But like, so my hair will definitely do that. But also, that's a lot of work to every morning get in the shower, condition it, detangle it, pick it out, and then shape it down. And then one of the tricks that my mom taught me in high school is like, if you take a paper towel and you pat it down with a paper towel, it's going to make it more even as you go around. So you have like a better circle. But again, it's a ton of work. So then I realized that I just get my hair wet, I condition it, do whatever, and when I shake it off, it curls up like this. And so that's when I got this obsession with wanting to look like Lenny Kravitz, because he's all that is man.
He's very cool. He was just like a cool dude.
Yeah, he still is. And still a cool dude. I don't even know how old he is. He's the man.
Yeah.
And so I was like, let me grow my hair out like Lenny Kravitz. And so forever I wanted a nose ring. And since I was like, like 14 or 15.
Okay.
Ooh, DDT on the apron from Logan Paul.
So more, so Kravitz, I was going to go with like LL Cool J.
No, not even close.
I mean, LL Cool J is cool though.
He's very cool. Lady Lover Cool James, always lick your lips because you can't buy chapstick for some reason. It's very confusing. All that.
Logan Paul.
I've already heard Logan Paul.
Retaining, by the way. And please, for the love of God, rivalry finished.
It's got to be, but that match was not entertaining.
That match was a good one.
What happened in it?
Tell
me one move that happened.
DDT on the apron.
Only because I said it.
I was watching. Relax.
Elias set up the ladder out here. They didn't get to use it.
Hey, we got a whole pay-per-view here. You think this is the first last Extreme Rules match we got?
No, but this is the first match of the show. This sets the tone.
We got lots going on here, son.
Wow.
Four and a half. That's set the tone.
I'm going to say no, sir, to that.
That does set the tone. That's rivalry complete. Thank you, my goodness.
Okay, so we continue. You good with that?
Four and a half. Love it. Four and a half opener. Beautiful. Beautiful. Rivalry complete. It's everything you wanted in life right there.
Great job. For everything you wanted in life.
That's right.
Bro, you know what? I want to see this tag team.
What tag team?
Ivar and Logan Paul.
That's a great team.
Okay, Penelope Perfect.
Penelope! Get it. Getting that poops. Grayson Waller taking on Adrian Buck.
Oh, yeah. Stone Cold with the run-in to keep the rivalry
going. Stone Cold with the run-in.
Iron Man. Oops, sorry.
We have a run-in, though, because I don't think we're... I think you have to simulate.
You're right.
You got to simulate.
Amazing match.
So we'll take four. And anything on the rivalry? No.
Nope, nothing.
Zaya, right, though, getting 9,000 fans. My goodness.
Love Zaya. She's great.
My goodness.
Out here killing it.
Whew.
Doing your brand a service, you know?
A lot of service right there. Io Doudrop. Title on the line, Extreme Rules.
Spectate.
Extreme Rules. Great people. We're doing solid.
You're doing a great job. Hey, I applaud you. Commissioner to Commissioner.
Yep.
You're doing a great job.
Thank you.
Io Sky, hold on, I'm gonna let her music play. Got a banger.
You like her music?
Love her music.
Favorite music.
But I can't hear
favorite music currently.
Io, is your favorite music?
No, yours.
Oh, Gender's old music. That's my favorite music currently.
Does he have new music?
Yeah. Because he's with his crew now. So they have different music. Gender's old music? It's like fighting for the top spot in my favorite music in wrestling.
Wow.
It's so good.
Is that up there with Billy and Chuck?
Yes, but that's, it's like a different couch. It's a lot. So like Billy and Chuck, like I can sing it in the car, I can feel it, but Gender's old music, bang.
It's true.
That song is unreal. Whose music was it that we used to dance to in developmental whenever they'd come out? We'd all get in the behind the curtain and dance. Obviously
on Calvin Reigns. On FC Dub.
Yeah. Was it Roman's music? Did he have bangers music?
Calvin Reigns had real good music.
When he was Leaki. And he raised his hand.
I don't think he had good music.
Who's got a question?
There's no way he had good music. Calvin Reigns we liked. And Titus O'Neil. Titus O'Neil.
Titus's was really good, yeah.
Titus's was very good.
Oh, man.
He had the custom track, right?
Yeah. that somebody had like really, it was like generic music number four, but it was like so good.
I don't know.
This feels like yesterday, but it was like 12 years ago.
Long time ago. I just remember Calvin and Calvin and Titus, they had the good ones.
I have Reigns' music on my computer.
I know you do. I know
Calvin Reigns is amazing. He hits hard like he plays for the Ravens. All hail as Calvin approaches the Baltimore King, so you know he's the dopest. Competition is hopeless. You flat on the mat when he steps through the ropes in. When it rains, pours, Calvin's outside, but stay indoors.
I love that line. Sure. I love that line. When it rains, it pours. Calvin's outside, better stay indoors. I like that. What do you remember? So do you remember what Titus's was?
No.
It was so good. It was a custom Titus. I wish I remembered it.
It was a custom Titus.
It was a custom Titus.
You can probably find it on YouTube.
I would think so, right? FC Dub.
Yeah.
It was great.
Let me see. I don't know. I will say Calvin Reigns' greatest music in FCW history.
It had to be.
Also, okay, and so those of you watching this, you can go along with this. So what I want to do is I want to have a show because we used to have promo day every Wednesday. That means that we come in and we cut a promo. I can give all these secrets, right? This is fine.
Why not? Yeah. FC Dub is long and gone.
Yeah, it's fine. We did the behind the curtain thing. We were both on ESPN. What up?
Breaking ground, son.
So we would have promo day every Wednesday. And it was either you come in, you cut a promo as your current gimmick or as something that you wanted to do, or you just kind of come in and talk. Like I went in multiple times and just did like spoken word for no reason.
True.
Because I was in that moment of my life. So I wanted to...
yeah. I'm a learned doctor doing the spoken word.
You wrestle for a hot dog and a soda, even though you don't wanna, but you don't get transportation on your bill. But you take bumps anyway. Like, what? What are you talking about?
deep, man.
Yeah, real thoughts.
Real deep.
Never gonna get called up. You stay in here forever. You know?
Sure.
Now I lost my train of thought. Titus music. Here we go. This is a nighttime.
What was that? I cut you off with your Lenny Kravitz, man.
Oh, yeah. So I wanted to be Lenny Kravitz when I was younger, when I was a teenager.
Did that ever stop, or you still want to be him?
I don't want to be him, but I would like to find the confidence and essence that he has and figure out what that means in adult me, I guess. Okay. A better way to put things. But I would do like kid talent shows, and I would get two fake nose rings and have a guitar, and I would sing American Woman.
Whoa.
American Woman.
I would love to see it. Whoa!
Okay, again, not a very extreme match, but it's over.
Doesn't have to be. We got more extreme coming your way.
Just plug him in. Just let him do it.
Yo, retaining. Retaining. Title's not changing hands here at Extreme Rules.
I gotta get my phone charger. I'll be right back.
Get your phone charger.
Just talk amongst yourself.
Well, I need you to advance the match. Four. Okay. Interesting enough here.
Four star.
Four, yeah.
Jeez.
So interesting enough, like I swear. Oh, maybe I didn't use it for this. So Extreme Rules was just the bonus. So I got that. I used a card for the run-in on the Iron Man. So that's why I got four. EO and Do was just a title match. Okay.
This show is a flying by.
It's a good show right here.
Hey. Hell of a nighttime show.
Hell of a nighttime show, dude.
For the people. Ambiance. I like a nighttime show.
New rivalry. I'll take that.
Okay. Yeah, new rivalry. Big take title
that.
Match.
Take that. Kicking it off.
Champion retains, and they get into an argument with the challenger who lost.
Clean. That's right. Hey, I rivalry beat you, stuff. But there's more to come.
Oh, yeah.
Stay tuned.
Club Barella. Nope. Popularity down. Embarrassing.
Give me that money, no?
$1,200. Okay, Julius Creed serving
spectated
him.
Up, son.
Damian spectated. Priest with the easy. Skeletor gear. Did you see it?
Yeah.
Bro, nasty.
Spectate, son.
Okay.
Yeah. Falls count anywhere.
Spectate.
Julius. Orange yes. Julius.
chilling at the mall, about to go to GameStop on your break and get that new Wii Mario Kart.
I'll get one Orange Julius and a bacon cheese dog, please.
Boom. Actually, you know what? You can do both things at the mall. You can go get an Orleans Julius and then have your Sunday praise, you know? Yeah. With your priest.
True.
Tastes good, feel good.
Tastes good, feel good. That's what they say.
That's what this match is. Who's they?
It's what they say, man. We don't question it.
No, never.
No.
Never. Okay. So I wanted to look like Lenny Kravitz so bad. And yep. So part of that was getting a nose ring, but I hate needles. And so over time, I never got over that fear, because whenever we have to like take blood at work or something,
sure. I'm
freaking out. I got to like sing Lionel Richie to calm myself down.
Hello.
Yeah. Is it needle? But then I got some tattoos, and my friend's like, oh, that's not like really like needles. It's like, fine, okay, whatever. And so last Monday, I was like, you know what?
Those are definitely needles, by the way.
But it's like different. It's
is
different.
It?
It is. It is. Go get a tattoo.
It's a needle stabbing you, dude.
It's different because like after like 15 seconds, it just kind of goes numb and you don't feel it unless it's in like a really bad spot, like on a bone or something.
Sounds like it hurts.
Because I have a needle like on my forearm. I have a needle of tattoo like on my forearm. I have one on my bicep, and then I have one across the back of my, excuse me, belching, tricep.
Yeah.
And so like it hurt a little more at like the elbow tip, but also too, it's different. Cause like a needle going into your arm to like draw blood is very different from a needle giving a tattoo.
Okay.
It's not piercing as many layers of skin.
Interesting.
But obviously an actual piercing is going all the way through your flesh.
Sure.
And so this was last Monday. I was like, you know what? The day before I woke up and I was like, you know what? Let me quit being a about this.
Today's the day.
I'm just gonna do it and see what happens. And who knows? 36 years old, maybe it's midlife crisis. And that's what I was worried about. But you know what? I saw it and I said, you know what? I like this. So I don't care what anybody else thinks because I like it. And that's when I know, or that's when I know.
That's when I know I was doing good.
Yeah, that's when I'm talking about my kids. And that's when I knew I was in a better place mentally. Because I said, I could not care less if anyone else likes this.
There you go.
Because I like it.
There you go. And if your midlife crisis is getting a nose ring, I mean, there's definitely worse midlife crises you could have.
Right?
Yeah, could happen.
When you see me driving around in like a brand new Corvette or something, then you're like, okay, you should calm down.
Yeah, could do that too.
No, my second one will be just, I'll get a hoop in the other nostril, because Lenny Kravitz has the stud in one,
yep.
And the hoop in the other one.
Yep.
And she goes, when she was doing it, she's like, what side do you want it in? I was like, the Lenny Kravitz side.
I want to look exactly like Lenny.
Yeah, Lenny Kravitz looks really cool.
It's great.
I was like, you know what? I am learning how to play bass guitar, so it kind of works out.
That works.
Yeah. That Bro, works. Dude is sick. Dude is sick, and I can't. You can't even, like, argue with that.
No one's arguing with it.
You know who's friends with him?
Who?
Big Show.
Friends with Lenny Kravitz?
Yeah. Big Show's like so cool.
What an odd friendship.
Yeah.
Where did that come from? I'd like to hear the story.
Yeah, right? We gotta get him on.
We gotta get him on.
Get them to let us talk to him.
Also,
I love Show, dude.
So you said you started watching a new show, or an old show, but revisiting it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, this is it. So I'm in season 3 of Dawson's Creek right now.
Oh.
Bro.
What a show, dude. I used to watch that. Every day, I would walk down to my friend Nick's house, and we would watch an episode of Dawson Creek, and then we'd walk to school.
Why would you watch Dawson's Creek in the morning?
It just happened to be on. Like, it was always on in the morning.
What? There wasn't, like, a cartoon or something you wanted to watch?
Uh-uh. It was always Dawson's Creek in the morning, and then if we came home after school, it was Dragon Ball Z and Pokemon were on.
Oh, yes. That was definitely. So what age range are you? What grade are you in at this point?
Probably grade 6, 7.
So you're in grade 7 watching Dawson's Creek.
Yeah.
Every morning before you go to school.
Every single morning.
Dawson's Creek is not for kids in 6th grade, I feel.
It's not like, it's not for them.
It definitely is not for them.
What? How?
So.
You make it sound like it's like some R-rated show. It is not.
It 100% is.
No, it is not.
Bro, I'm watching it right now as a grown man.
Wait,
with children.
What's so bad about it?
So
it's very mild.
No, it's not.
What? Bro, okay, example.
Okay, so I thought, what I remembered from the show was that Pacey hooked up with his teacher.
Yes.
Okay, not okay, right? So I thought this happened like deep into season two. This starts in episode one, where they explain that every main character on this show is 15 years old.
Yes.
They hit it like three different times.
Yep.
And then I don't know how many more times they explain that Joey, who is, what's her name? Oh, here we go, pinfall on the floor after the Big Show slams it out.
Extreme Rules.
Boom, oh! There you go. Great match, Damian Priest, Skeletor wins. Joey, what's her name, dude? Katie Holmes.
Yeah, Katie Holmes.
Katie Holmes' character, her sister is dating a black man, and they feel the need to say that she's got a black boyfriend like seven times because at the time, I guess interracial dating is just like not okay. And then she's pregnant with his baby, so like the whole town, which is like a tiny beach town, is just like gossipy and freaking out about it.
Sure.
They talk about how they're 15. Pacey, he meets his like teacher who's in her mid-30s at the video store, and they start this storyline right then. Yeah. Everything is just hypersexual from the jump.
But it is not. Rated R.
Tell me what pop era
culture. It's pop culture like controversial relevancy. Sure.
At that point in time, not rated R. At this point in time, 100% rated R.
No way.
The show
There's no swearing in it. There's no nudity.
The show is very much, at least.
It's a hot button topic, though. It's controversial.
Here, sorry. Let's start this match and then start talking again. and they're going to be so mad at us. Everyone watching this thing. They talked about Dawson's Creek for 20 minutes.
Dawson's Creek for 20 minutes.
Great show.
Great show. Fantastic. Holds up.
Okay, what do we have here?
Liv Raquel, Extreme Rules.
Let's spectate.
Big main event. Big main right. event. Level 4 rivalry, by the way.
Level 4, goodness. This might be a star.
I got to say, I'm a little disappointed that I have not had a 5-star yet.
I'm not.
I am.
Well, that's unfortunate for you.
But I guess, you know what? Julius and Priest, Julius and Priest are not even
which,
in a rivalry.
Hold on, check this out. Let me show you something.
Oh, this is just booking because you messed up my order here. So that was literally just a match. That was just a match because Julius could not go with Logan. And Priest is just one of my guys. Okay. Yes, because you took out...
Bro, you didn't know.
What?
You didn't know, did you?
You didn't know what?
You didn't know.
Nice ambiance, though, dude.
Let me show you. You didn't know.
Setting
did
that
you?
Ambiance.
You didn't know, did
nighttime.
You? Bro, you didn't know I had this, did you?
I did know you had that.
Mob Madness.
Yeah.
In the Saran Wrap. You can't open it. I collect board games. I'm not a weirdo, I promise.
Okay. Interesting enough. Mob Madness. Probably more your one that you like as opposed to a collectible.
No, I think Mob Madness is 100% a collectible.
Is it though?
Yes, 100% it is.
I got some board games from like 1970s.
Yeah.
Well, actually, they might even be like 1960s. And they're kind of cool. They're like the old one. I like them.
Not as cool as Mob Madness though.
It's pretty cool. I got one.
What are they? Name them.
One is called KGB.
Does anybody in the audience know that? No.
What do you mean, does anybody in the audience know that?
I feel like it's a pretty straightforward question. Does anyone in the audience know that?
What, the game KGB?
No, the pie pumpkin.
What are you talking about?
What are you talking about? I don't understand how you think I'm talking about something that's not KGB.
You know what, that's fine. That's fine. Well, Madden is the greatest board game ever made, apparently.
I didn't say that. I got 13 dead in drive
even
over
worse,
here, too.
Even worse, why don't you take the wrap off and play, bud?
Because it's a collectible, dude.
What's the point? You gotta play.
No, I can get another one and play that.
Why don't you have another one and play that?
Why would I bring the other one over here if it's already open and the pieces are everywhere?
But do you have another one?
Of course not, because it's too expensive.
That's ridiculous.
What do you mean it's ridiculous?
You're sitting there, you're Mall Madness, you wouldn't even play Mall Madness? You're thinking, you're sitting there talking about Mall Madness.
Of course not. I have Drop Mix. Why am I going to play Mall Madness?
Play whatever you want.
And that's exactly what I'm doing. I'm not playing Mall Madness
because you don't
have
it.
It's wrapped up.
No, you're not going to unwrap it. You're standing by the collectibles.
Coming from the guy who busts open packs of cards pretty much for a living, but I feel like you would understand this.
No, but I do that.
Yeah, and I do this.
Nah, I don't like it.
What are you talking about?
You gotta play.
You gotta, you find, you gotta use your cards and not get them graded.
I do use the cards. I get them graded.
What do you use your cards for? Your baseball cards that you get?
To grade them.
You grade them?
I grade them.
So you don't play, you don't like play with them?
No, because
what about, what about your Pokemon cards? You don't, you play Pokemon with them?
I don't.
No, you don't. You don't. You don't even know how to play the Pokemon card game.
Yes, I do.
I completely doubt that.
Oh my god. What a claim.
I'm questioning you.
See, now you're just getting ridiculous because you're offended because you haven't played your stupid Malt Madness game.
First off, you don't need to call it stupid.
I will though.
Because I don't appreciate that.
I've chosen to call it stupid because I don't even think you have any clue how to play it.
That's disrespect to the people who made the game.
If we set up Malt Madness, you wouldn't even know where to start.
And?
That's, you don't know how to play.
What does that even mean?
You're a Malt Madness poser is what you are.
No, I'm not. I knew I wanted Malt Madness because I have played it before. And just because I haven't played it in a long time doesn't mean that I don't enjoy the game.
I don't think you know how to play.
No, I'm telling you.
That's why you haven't unwrapped it to play it, is because you don't know how to play
it. Well, I haven't unwrapped it to play it because there's three tiny children that live in my house and the pieces will go missing forever.
I don't know. You got little stuff all over the place.
No, I don't. Everything that I have collectible-wise is wrapped up and displayed on shelves.
I don't know about this.
It's very, very specific in my house.
Sounds sketchy.
They're not even allowed down here without me.
Well, then there you go. Mom Madness is safe down there.
It is safe down here. What point are you trying to make?
Anyway, Dawson's Creek.
Dude, what a show.
Is that why you ran off and grabbed Mom Madness? Why did you run off and grab Mall Madness anyway?
Because you should have called that one match Mall Madness because you can get an Orange Julius and Praise both places in the mall. Mall Madness.
Nah, I'm not going to do that.
It's extreme.
I'm not going to do it because it's your idea.
The match would have probably got more stars if it was inside of a mall.
How dare you?
Shout out Town Center Mall. Marietta, let's go.
Anyway, Dawson's Creek.
Marietta, stand up.
Marietta.
Yeah. Raise up. Take your shirt off. East Cobb, let's go!
Like a helicopter.
I saw a video of Petey Pablo doing that song at a wedding. Oh, there's a finish.
At a wedding?
At a wedding. So I guess the people wanted to do a destination wedding, so they did it in North Carolina.
Yep.
Oh, that's it. Wow. These matches were not extreme at all. And you kept saying, oh, next match is extreme. There's more extreme rules matches. These were not extreme.
Make sure you tune in next week.
Tune in to see Kimona Wanalea dance atop of the ECW arena.
That was a level 4 rivalry. It has to be a 5-star.
You'll be like, hey, if it's 3.5, my dude. Come on.
It's got to be 5.
Flex it
5 up. And rivalry complete.
Damn. Ooh, 3.5. You know 5 stars for me.
My God. What?
Wow. That sucks.
What is happening?
That sucks.
That's garbage.
Bro, I love a nighttime pay-per-view.
Nighttime PPV is okay.
Nighttime PPV, I ain't mad at it.
Nighttime PPV is okay.
We should always do nighttime PPV.
I'm okay with it.
Especially because you won't get 5 stars if it's nighttime. WCW.
First off, WCW has to step it up right here.
Bro, Leviathan versus Finn Balor. This is about to be a banger for the title heavyweight championship WCW.
Look at 64 popularity. Ugh.
Bro, killing it.
Robbery?
Level 4. They were supposed to finish it last pay-per-view, but you screwed them.
It happens.
This is madness, but it's extreme rules, so let's spectate. Okay. WCW, where the big people play. Let's go.
Big people?
Big people. What do you mean, big people? Big peeps
play.
Bro, so when I go to the gym, we're bouncing around everywhere. We have to finish this conversation. Lenny Kravitz conversation is done, right?
Lenny Kravitz wrapped up, done.
I wanted to look like Lenny Kravitz, so I got my nose pierced. Moving on. What else do we need to finish?
Dawson Creek.
Dawson's Creek. Incredible show. I started watching it because I told my friend, I was like, bro, you got to watch Dawson's Creek. They're like, fine, I'll watch Dawson's Creek. I was like, let me rewatch it because I only remember a few things about
Skip these entrances, son.
I'm skipping him. Mike Romy Rome has to speak. Let him make his money, right, dude.
Dawson Creek.
Look at him, Leviathan. I had a WWE magazine.
Yeah.
And there's a foldout of Leviathan in developmental. And I remember thinking, like, who is this? I've never seen this guy. And then he showed up on the scene with Reverend Devon.
That's right.
And I was like, please come on in. Finn about to tear him up. Who knew Leviathan would turn into Batista?
Who knew?
But you remember when he would come out with the no music and there's just spotlight?
Mm-hmm.
Bro, that was so sick. That was, I'll be honest. When he was doing all of his Batista stuff, I was like, okay, this is cool. But when he started doing that type of stuff, that's when I like, I fully was like, I will never not be a Batista guy. It was, really? I don't know. Yeah, bro, I don't know what it was. Did he do a promo sitting in a wheelchair one time? I think I remember.
That sounds familiar.
But like, for whatever reason, like when they would take out, because obviously like he's a huge dude. He sure. looks incredible. He's got all the tattoos. He looks super intimidating. But then like the music and the pyro, all of it's really cool.
Yep.
But I love the idea of stripping everything away. And then you say, what do you have?
True.
When all of the glitz and the glam and the pyro and the music and the video walls, when those are gone, what exists? And that I feel like as a kid or as a teenager, whatever it was, for whatever reason, that resonated with me so much harder than anything else. And I was like, yo, Batista is that guy. Like it was like the most captivating thing in wrestling to me at the time when he was doing that stuff.
Yep.
Not that the other stuff wasn't good. Please don't get me wrong. But that just hit me.
Okay. Okay.
Complete other tangent. Anyway.
Back to Dawson's Creek.
Dawson's Creek. So, yeah. It's a wild show, and obviously they're 15. And if you're older and watching this, which I imagine you are, I imagine most kids don't watch this show. So let's say you. No, I'm saying watching this Battle of the Brands.
Oh yeah.
I imagine our crowd is like 20 and up.
Maybe. We probably got a good mix.
Okay, well, kids, when you're old enough to be watching Dawson's Creek, ask your parents, and you'll see. It's on Hulu, but if it's on Hulu, they didn't buy the rights to the theme song, I don't think, because it's some weird song. But on Max.
I don't want
to
wait.
Yeah.
It doesn't play?
No, it's some random song.
Oh my god. But on Max. What's happening here?
There's not even a reason to watch the show if you don't have that.
That's right.
But so it's not HBO Max, it's just regular Max now, right? Mm. We call it HBO Max in my house. They have the real theme song.
Sure.
So ask your parents. If your parents are cool with it, take a look. If you're at that point in life, it's good to watch. So they're all 15, so they're going through these 15-year-old problems, and they're all just like ridiculous and super sure. reactive on everything. And then you realize as they get older throughout the show, you're like, oh, like I did this stuff. Like I was illogical. I was ridiculous. I just reacted to things. And then by the time you're in season 3, and they start having these like super deep conversations, and you're like, oh wow, James Vanderbeek can act his ass off.
Yeah, yeah.
What? This is incredible.
Vanderbeek's solid, bro.
Yeah, so spoilies, if you haven't watched it, whatever, just like you're gonna figure it out. So his parents get divorced, right? So they're kind of going through this back and forth and stuff. He meets this girl, and they're talking about his parents getting divorced, and the way that they talk about it, like he gets to a certain point and he gets super choked up and like leaves, but it's like this is like intense. This is good. This is good conversation, and like what's the word? It's a good example of characters acting through things that happen in real life.
Sure.
To where it doesn't just seem like super corny stuff, you know? And so for me, it took to get to like season 3 for me to go like, oh wow, they're like really spent. I don't know if they got new writers or what, or they're just going through the evolution of people getting older. So by the time you're 17, you don't obviously don't fully understand life at all, and you never really do.
How many seasons are there?
I think 6.
6.
Yeah.
I don't know if I ever saw the finale of it.
I don't think I did either.
I don't think I did.
In that side of things, I'm kind of excited to see what happens.
Which also, Pacey, by the way, great career. Dawson's Creek, Mighty Ducks. Come on.
Yeah. So on. I didn't even realize he was in Mighty Ducks.
Oh my God, yeah.
The only Charlie, thing I remember dude? From Mighty Ducks is Keenan in Slapshot.
Goldberg. Oh no, wait, he's not Goldberg. He's the knuckle puck guy.
He's the main character, right?
Who?
Pacey.
Pacey is Charlie. He's the main character, yeah. He's the kid of, or... No, he's not the kid of Emilio Estevez. Yeah.
Is he? He's like too.
I feel like he's like he's Emilio's dating somebody and it's her kid.
But is he the main kid on the team?
Basically, yeah.
So see that, I have to watch Mighty Ducks again because I literally only remember that Keenan was in that movie. I don't remember any other kids.
But Goldberg was the goalie.
Bill Goldberg was the goalie.
Not Bill Goldberg. Goldberg was the goalie.
What other Goldberg are we supposed to talk about?
From Good Burger, dude. From Good Burger.
Goldberg.
You know, but I don't know his name. But he's been in lots of stuff.
Uh oh, Double Stomp coming. Ooh, and the guts. And Leviathan take it. He's calling my name.
And Keenan was knuckle buck.
And he retains.
Wow. Is that Extreme Rules?
Yeah.
That wasn't very extreme.
It was very extreme. They actually hit each other with
the chair. They set up the ladder and didn't use it. Same but complaint you had about mine.
No, incorrect, because your people didn't use any weapons. My people used the stairs. Because on WCW, where the big people play.
Big people play.
4.5.
Rivalry complete.
Rivalry complete. Let me write that down in my Boys and Girls Club book, because I am an alumni. Boys and Girls Club Hall of Fame. So if you do beat me, you are making a statement against the Boys and Girls Club
that
of America.
That is not true.
As a Canadian, I think that is an act of war. I will assume.
What are you talking about? And this is, by the way, I don't know where we're at when this airs, but this is, it was just Canada Day.
Oh, congratulations.
Thanks.
Oh, Canada.
Also, just about to be Independence Day tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. What's the story of Canadian Independence Day?
Well, I don't think we call it Canadian Independence Day. I think we just call it Canada Day. I think it's the day that Canada was declared a country, right? That's what I'm thinking. Same as Independence Day.
Yeah, and we have like a whole story. What's yours? What's the Canada one? The Canadian one?
I don't know. I think people just went to Canada.
Oh, people just showed up to Canada. They're like, hey, we're independent. Cool, here's our day.
Yeah, we're going to live in Canada.
Like a, there wasn't like a war or a battle?
No,
or...
there's no civil war, no nothing. Not that I know of.
So you guys didn't learn about Canada Day?
We learned Canadian history. I would be interested as an adult to go back and learn a little bit more, because I remember in school it was very boring. There was not a lot to it, but I think there was. It was like the Underground Railroad. I remember I used to see like clips. There was like commercials that used to play all the time.
Commercials for the Underground Railroad?
It was like the railroad, because I want to say it was like, basically the railroad was made by like either the Chinese, and so it was like a big thing. It was like a big kind of a big deal that like they went in and like they'd have to blow up these like tunnels and stuff, like this rock. Yeah. They'd have to get all this rock. It was super dangerous.
Yeah,
but I saw commercials about this all the time.
Tracks. Give me 2 seconds. My light went out probably a long time ago.
Ambiance, dude. That's what I told you when you came back. I said ambiance.
Okay.
It was when you grabbed Maul Madness. Geez. It was when you grabbed Maul Madness.
I think it was when I plugged in my phone.
Maybe.
Okay, cage match here. So this is the deal. Drew got hurt, and he was in a 1 or 2 week rivalry. With Giovanni.
Yep.
And since he was out, it went stale because I was doing no call-outs because Drew, felt needed to rest. And now we've got a...
Wait, so this is stale or no?
Bro, we got a card on this mug.
Ah.
Yeah, come on. We're not going in stale on the pay-per-view in Extreme Rules.
Stale pay-per-view.
But,
I mean, it's still stale. You just have a card on.
Bro, Drew Giovanni could never be stale. Don't you disrespect him like that.
Stale.
Never.
It is.
So, what's the story of independence for Canada Day?
I don't know. I don't think there wasn't a war. There wasn't anything crazy.
So then what's, like, an interesting Canadian fact?
I think it's just when they declared Canada a country.
No one was messing with them? I highly doubt that at that point in time. Like,
who would be messing with them?
Britain, the UK, the French, somebody from over there. They were always messing with everybody, weren't they?
I don't think so.
Yeah,
they're
messing
so.
With. So you're telling me they were messing with the states, but not with right above the states?
Well, they weren't messing with the states. Where were they messing with the states?
What?
At this point, aren't we talking like civil war, where it's like states are messing with states?
I don't know when the Canadians were.
No, I'm talking about the U.S.
Yeah, I know, but Independence Day has nothing to do with the Civil War. It's a completely different thing. They gained independence from Britain. And then later the Civil War happened between the states. But in order for there to be a Civil War, you have to get rid of whatever oppressor or person from there is there.
But yeah, no, they weren't. I don't think they did that to Canada.
the Canadian people were just like, oh, we found some ground to build houses on. Well,
I
think,
so I'm curious, I would have to look at the dates of, like, I'm pretty sure Canada was established well after the U.S. So maybe they just considered it part of the U.S.?
What?
I don't think Canada's as old as the U.S., bro.
I'm not saying that. I'm just saying, like, what's... You don't know, like, anything about Canada?
No. Not that, not in, like, those terms. Where would I know? Why would I know this?
Because you're from there.
That doesn't mean anything.
You don't care?
We never really learned it.
He said, nah.
We never really learned it.
Nah, I don't know anything about Canada. Nah.
We learned, like, certain things, but nah, nothing stands out.
So what did you learn?
About what?
About Canada.
Like, just in general?
I learned, like, about, like, its origins. Like, what do you know about Canadian history?
Honestly, like, nothing. Nothing.
They didn't teach anything in school?
I think they did, but I just didn't really pay attention.
Oh.
And also, at this point, I'm coming up on, like, that was 20 years ago. That's a long time.
Yeah.
Which also, by the way, have you gone to any of your reunions?
High school?
Yeah.
No.
So me neither. I didn't go to 5, 10, 15. I don't even know if there is, but 20's coming up. 20 for me would be 2026.
When did you graduate?
2006.
I graduated in 2004.
2024. So your 20 years coming up next year.
Oh man, I want to go.
Are you gonna go?
Hell yeah, I'm gonna go.
I feel like you have to.
Bro, that'd be sick.
Did you like school though?
Like, yeah, I enjoyed school.
Did you enjoy high school? Because I feel like there's, you either love high school or you hate it.
Yeah. So I was very lucky. So, like, I was like a chameleon. I hung out kind of with everybody. Oh, here we go. Drew with the kick. Is he gonna hit it? Giovanni reverse. Nope.
Vinovici.
So I was, here we go. 1, 2, 3. Ooh, that's Drew it. McIntyre in the cage match. What do we have here?
What level rivalry were they?
0.
0, but with a card.
In the cage match with a card. And it's Drew. Everybody loved to see Drew. Everybody loves from Drew McIntyre. My son was freaking out because he had came out with his sword. He cared about nothing else.
That's, yes, yes.
He's got a sword!
Ah! The sword looks cool, too.
It looks awesome. Okay, how many stars, though? How many stars? Wolfman. Ask for Donald. There we go. 4.5. Let's go. 4.5 stars with a card. No rivalry. I love it.
I don't like it.
I love it. Okay. Drew's big too. Oh, and a new rivalry. Okay, monstrous. I'm into that. Yeah.
Monstrous.
One level rivalry. Yeah, he's a large human.
Large human.
Okay. Dana Brooke calls out Bailey. Weak rivalry grows.
Rivalry growing though. 2 to 3.
Let's go. Okay. 3 level rivalry. Boom. And then mid-card match. Big normal.
Oh, kombucha.
It's gonna be rough.
Did you put a card on this one?
Nope. It's a normal tag match.
Kombucha and Book against Steiner and Red Flame.
Hey, we got it.
Okay.
This is gonna be 2.5 stars.
Do the styles match up?
Yes, I think. I don't know.
We'll see.
Who knows? Why did I book this match? Because I didn't have the ability to book anything else. So, And I think if I would have played a card, it was like doubling up, so you could only play one type of card.
That's right. Because I think you were going to put this in a cage, but you can't use two cages.
Yeah, yeah.
And kombucha, though.
Yeah, kombucha killing it with the wings.
Red Flame.
Red Flame.
Also, I don't know about you, but I have gotten so many messages about Red Flame, or like people on their game making Red Flame their champion and like killing it.
I'm glad for you and I'm glad for Red Flame. I will say I haven't seen them because I have deleted Twitter and Instagram for like the past 2 months.
Whoa, fully.
I get on when I like need to post something. Yep, if it's like a sponsored something, I post it. Because I realize, and bro, I can't tell you how much better my brain feels.
Oh my God, yeah.
Because as much as, you know, we might talk about Twitter and like how we don't want it to affect us and everything, like you can't, maybe there's people that can, maybe they're on a better plane than I am, but like someone will say something, like I'll see like 100 nice comments and then one mean, one or weird one, mm-hmm. and then that's the one I'm like thinking about for like the rest of the day, and yeah. it's like, oh man,
we don't like your nose ring, dude.
Yeah, I'm not showing anyone. This is the first time the public
eat you alive for a week.
Old me would be like, oh, I got my nose pierced. Let me show the world. Nah. Who cares what everybody thinks, my dude?
Sure.
I like this. If you guys like it too, that's great. Awesome. Appreciate it. If you don't like it, so what? It's all good.
So you found you literally have to take them out of your life.
I have to. I have a problem. I have to delete them off my phone.
Wow. You can't even hide them in a folder or something.
No, because then I naturally. So this is my deal. I go to take a poop.
Yep.
And then I pick up my phone and I start swiping, and I go to Twitter and I swipe, 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 swipe. Go to Instagram and I swipe, 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 swipe. And I go to my search page and like, oh, this is funny. Then I watch this 30-second video that leads me to like a minute and a half video.
Yep.
And my friend is like, here's this funny TikTok. And I'm like, I don't have TikTok on my phone because I know that I'm already bad enough on Twitter and Instagram that I'm going to go deeper on TikTok. So I just keep them off my phone. And legit, like, I haven't felt this good, like, brain-wise in, I don't know, maybe 4 or 5 years.
See, now when you're needing something to do or look at, so like I after every workout I use my sauna, mm-hmm. and I need like something to do for 15-20 minutes. So that's why I started playing the Final Fantasy games. I needed something to like take up that time, because I didn't want to just sit there and like scroll on Instagram or whatever. Because I've actually, for some reason, Instagram and Twitter has never affected me. And I think it's because I always just tell myself, like, if I wouldn't ask somebody for advice, then I'll never take their critique.
Yes.
So, like, and if I tell myself that, then it doesn't, nothing affects me. And then, again, in those times, instead of just scrolling aimlessly, I just play Final Fantasy. Hmm.
That's very smart. I've switched to just watching a bunch of stand-up comedy on YouTube.
That works. I think you just need to find your thing, you know?
Yeah. But, yeah, I legit, like, I feel so much better, and so... I have it on my phone right now because I have to post some stuff today.
Sure.
Or I'll post like, oh, we're doing this UpUpDownDown thing. Oh, they're going to get counted out, and this match is going to be over very soon.
Kombucha, Kombucha, dude. Ring.
9.
Okay. Wow, kind of close.
Really just, red flame in the corner? So yeah, I shut it off, and I've just been doing everything to like, I guess, be more present.
Sure. With
the people that are actually in my life rather mm-hmm. than the people that are on the internet.
Nothing wrong with that.
And being on the internet, I don't believe is a bad thing at all. But I don't know if it's my algorithm and what I've clicked onto or what, or if it's just Twitter. But I feel like, at least in my stuff, the only stuff that I see is people dunking on people so that they can get likes.
Yeah, I've started to just like unfollow a lot of things. So like on Twitter, I've actually... I don't know. I'm not really on Twitter much because most of the time I just get tagged in like weird NFT scams, and then I'm like, I don't want this. So then I'm blocking people left and right, and then like, what's the friggin' point of this? So like, I'll kind of do the same as you, like hop on to advertise something. But Twitter sometimes, like, if it's actually my source of news, so like if anything goes down, I always check on like what's trending or whatever, and then it's like, oh
yeah,
people are talking about this, I get informed on it, and then I'm good to go. But like, yeah, if there's just people randomly insulting each other, I'm like, yeah, I don't need to follow any of you guys or see any of this. So it's like block, see ya.
Well, it's like so too, like, and I think it's the algorithm thing, like it'll just show you stuff that it thinks you're gonna like at this point now, because everything changed like a few months ago with like Musk.
Yep.
So there's just a bunch of stuff on there, and then like the ads and random tweets. And then, like, you'll see, like, oh, this is kind of funny. And then you click on it, and, like, oh, I want to read the comments for this. Yep. And the comments are, like, then you find somebody arguing. And now it's, like, two hours later.
Are you a comment reader?
Oh, 100%.
So I've never read comments, ever.
Bro.
I have no interest in the comments on posts or anything.
That's what I turned into, because, like, I'll admit, I was part of the problem. I was exactly what I now don't want to like be a part of.
You were a commentator.
Oh, 100%. And I was a commenter, but not like in a, oh, I want to fight somebody. Like I would be in, like I would someone would comment on something that I posted and say something mean to someone else. And then I'm jumping in trying to like diffuse arguments and stuff when it's like, you know what? Let me just, I'm just not going to post anything. Mm-hmm. I'm just not going to post anything. If I feel like the need to post something, then I'm going to make sure that it's like, I really feel like I have to do this. So now I've got to download the app. I've got to think of the post. I've got to put the picture or the video, whatever. So like that way I'm not just like randomly posting stuff just because I have an extra 5 minutes. Like,
sure.
Because then I'm taking that time away from like, I'm taking that time away from people like you. Mm. In my who people who are actually in my life, sure. That I actually have their phone number, that I actually want to speak to, that yep. I actually value your opinion and want to like be a better person because I know someone who's as good as you. You know what I mean?
There you go.
And so rather than forcing myself to interact with like a bunch of like negative comments that have nothing to do with anything that I really care about.
Yep. Yep.
And I'm not saying that that's Twitter. I'm saying that like that was me.
It's. I mean, we've all been sucked in at one point or another. You know.
Yeah.
Getting a little Twitter argument.
We're getting deep at
night. It's, I'm telling you, the ambiance of the nighttime PPVs, man. It's a whole different vibe here.
Bro, it's crazy.
Whole different vibe.
Did we finish? Did we wrap up our other conversations?
Dawson Creek.
We wrapped it up, right?
I think so.
Great show. Go watch it.
Great show. Go watch it. Not rated R, but controversial.
I mean, it's heavy though. Like you shouldn't be watching it if you're 7. You know.
Well, not when you're 7.
If you're like 12.
I'm pretty sure I'm not like even 12.
If you're like 14.
Yeah, 12, 14. Same then it's age. The same as just the guys on the show. They said it was they were what, 14, 15?
They were 15.
15.
It's an example of preparing you for what life is like as far as your emotional status and sure. Learning how to talk through things. And not understanding how to talk through things, so you just get mad, and then realizing, oh, I'm mad because of this. I should handle this.
You know, I gotta rewatch it because I don't remember it being that heavy.
Bro, you got to rewatch it. Oh, Booker T with the X kick.
Got it.
On the
Dogfest Graham, dude.
Red Flame, bro. Red Flame said no.
Red Flame and the Dogfest Graham. That Dogfest Graham.
What if he wanted to be a model? What if he wanted Rick Martel's gimmick?
Dogfest Graham.
Yeah, and he's like, not I'm not a dog face. Like, no, you're dog face.
The dude. Model, Rick Steiner.
Bro, he looks like a dog. No, a I dog don't.
Dog face gremlin.
No, I don't. Oh, yeah, I don't is know. It? It's the bulldog?
Whoa! Bro, it's
the bulldog. Dog face grim.
Dog face grim picking up a dub, dude. Your prediction, 2.5?
No, at least a 4. Come on. Come on, guys. Help me out.
No rivalry?
No rivalry.
Matching flaming, styles?
Flaming kombucha. Okay. Good styles. Give me a 3. They'll give me at least
popularity?
A 2.5. And kombucha's hurt.
Out, dude.
Bro, you just got in here. Influencers wanting to get in and getting hurt.
Kombucha basically like leveraged his way in.
But he is wrestling for free, so.
That's true. But now he's not because he's injured. Kombucha
injured for 2 weeks. 2.5.
And you got a new rivalry going.
Great.
Kombucha and Book. Steiner and Flame, dude. Great. Red Flame ready to tear it up, son.
Bro, I'm about to make this tag team hot.
Dogface Graham and Red Flame?
Hell yeah, both of them.
Kombucha.
Both teams.
And Book.
Kombucha will be a Bad Bunny versus Kevin Nash. Let's go. Iron Man 1-on-1.
You know, it's a funny story. I actually worked a show in Dawson's Creek.
What?
And Kevin Nash was on the show, and so was Viscera.
Was James Vanderbeek there?
No. No.
Joshua Williams?
No.
Katie Holmes?
No. But Big Daddy V was there, dude.
Hell yeah.
Big Daddy V and Kevin Nash in the main.
Oh, in the main.
Trevor Murdoch and Lance Cade were there.
Bro. Did Big Daddy V need to do anything cool? Because, you know, he was in Backyard Dogs.
Who?
Big Daddy V.
I didn't know that.
You don't remember Backyard Dogs?
I do because the...
Black Ranger.
The Black Ranger was in it.
He was great.
He was also just in a show called The Shield that I was just watching.
He's in The Shield?
Yeah.
The Black Ranger?
Yeah, his name's Rondell. He's a, like awesome. A gang leader. He just died though.
What?
He just died.
Oh, in the show.
In the show.
I was like,
yeah, in the
bro,
show.
I was about to break down.
No.
Dude, don't do that to me.
I said Rondell died, not.
Okay.
You what's, just it, said what's, he his died. What's his name? What's the actor's name? You should know this. You should definitely know
it's,
this.
It's nighttime.
No, I can't blame it on
it's
that.
It's nighttime. Like, I can't.
You've idolized him for years and years.
It's nighttime, and I've had a long day.
I want to say his name is Zach, but it is not Zach.
It's, well, Zach in the show.
Yeah, that's right. Walter? Is his name Walter?
Walter Jones. There we go.
Walter Jones. I remembered it before you.
There we go. Well, once you said
goodness.
Walter, I told you I've had a long day. My 6-year-old
goodness.
Banged his head off the concrete and got a concussion. I have to go get a CT scan. I'm having a rough day.
Okay. Take it easy.
Okay?
Take it Jeez. Easy, man.
Jeez.
Which he's okay, by the way.
He's fine. He's good. We're out here entertaining the people. Hey, let's talk about the thing now.
What's the thing?
What are you doing on Saturday?
Ooh, big match, bud. Big match.
Hell yeah. Hell big yeah, match. Dude.
Back after 2 years out there wrestling around.
I'm excited.
Ridiculous.
Who are you wrestling?
Knoxville, Tennessee.
You're wrestling the entire town of Knoxville, Tennessee?
I'm wrestling everybody at once.
I'm
wrestling Matt Cross, who I'm fairly sure I've met, but I've never wrestled. But he's very good.
Mm-hmm.
He's very good.
He's on Tough Enough.
He was on Tough Enough. That's right. How you remember that, but not Walter Jones? Ridiculous.
Because, one, obviously, like I said, I've had a very traumatic day today.
Okay.
And two,
not traumatic
he was voted
enough
off.
To remember that he was on Tough Enough.
He was voted off early on Tough Enough, which was very upsetting to me because he's an extremely talented person that I figure would have just gotten a contract regardless and did not. And it was baffling.
Wait, which Tough Enough? OG Tough Enough?
No, this most recent, the one with Hackman, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he was on that one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Wow.
And so like they voted him off because they're like, oh, you don't have like a gimmick, your charisma, like personality thing. And it's like, okay, well, like, we have a performance center, don't we?
Yeah, M-Dog,
just,
dude.
Like, what do you think people don't have? Just show them how to have, and damn. We'll go. This guy is so good at wrestling. Just
M-Dog, man. M-Dog. I swear he's been a part. He's been part of some stuff, though. He was never in TNA
yeah.
over there.
Mm,
I feel like he'd be like a good X Division guy.
My memory is so spotty with everything in life. No, but he's freaking awesome.
Yeah,
I'm excited you get
super
to
fun. Ease me back, and ease me back in.
And it's for the title.
That's for the end. Yeah.
Tyler Breeze hasn't wrestled in 2 years. He comes in, politics his way into a title shot.
Yeah. I think it'd just be best if I win it. You know.
As a GM yourself, what do you think the best call is here?
I'm thinking we get some mileage out of this. You know, I think we book the first one. I figure, you know, I win the title. It's exciting. I'm back, you know. Then we book the second one, you know, former champion against new champion. I'm thinking, you know, good back and forth, but I think I go over again, you know. And then probably we need a third one now, you know, because
yeah.
it was close, the second one.
Yep.
And then I think that one's just like a, yeah, no, you're not getting the title back. This is mine now.
Oh, there's no comeuppance.
No.
Oh, okay. This sounds like a really good. This sounds great. This sounds like something I want to watch.
A real riveting story, you know?
Yeah.
You win the title.
Straight.
You continue to win, and then you just win.
Gotcha. Oh, yeah. I want to see this.
That's it.
Oh, Bad Bunny kicked out of the choke slam. Let's go.
Just over 10 minutes left. Iron Man.
Yo, man.
Ooh.
Oh, here we go. The jackknife. Let's take you up and gravity do its job, baby.
Kevin Nash might have my favorite powerbomb.
Mm. That's it. Bad Bunny couldn't. Oh, it's Iron Man. Oh, yeah.
It's Iron Man.
We got 10 more minutes. Yeah, he's got your favorite powerbomb?
I think so.
Really?
I think so. I don't know who would beat him.
Top rope? Lies. Kevin Nash? Top rope? Lies.
Yeah, he didn't go out there.
Not a Sid?
Sid had a good one, too.
Mm-hmm.
But I think Jackknife is a little more impressive. And I think it's because he called it a jackknife.
That's the only reason.
I mean, everybody else did a powerbomb. He did a jackknife powerbomb. It's
Cool. What does that mean, though?
I mean, it's just cool. It just sounds cool. Big Daddy Cool.
Let me see. Yeah, it is cool. He is cool. I'm trying to think of power bombs. Mike Awesome's power bomb was sick, though.
Mike Awesome had an awesome bomb, yeah.
Bro, power bombing you outside of the ring through tables? Come on, dude.
It's true. It's true.
That's so sick. You think...
not including tables, though.
Okay.
Just a straight P-bomb, dude.
P-bomb. Okay, I like Batista's.
Batista bomb.
Ooh, also, I like Ahmed Johnson's. I know it's a double underhook, but that's Pearl still a power Riv. Bomb. Pearl River Plunge?
Dude, the Pearl River was badass.
Give me a PRP. Come on. Shoulder, what is it? Knee pads on the shins?
Yeah, I might be with you on the PRP. Yeah. Pearl River Plunge was really cool.
Yeah, man. And also, you know what? I'm gonna say I think Too Cold Scorpio had my favorite powerbomb.
Really?
He had a nasty powerbomb. So he would wrestle Sabu for the TV title, and it was so nasty. And it was like in the middle of the match, like for no reason. To like no, there was no cover. He just powerbombed the hell out of him.
Oh God.
I'm gonna find it.
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, but if I go out of this, you can't see the game anymore, can you?
Yeah.
I mean, it's working.
Stay in it, stay in it.
Fine. Bad Bunny out here doing work.
I don't think Bad Bunny has what it takes to take him down.
You don't think so?
God, no. Jackknife Powerbomb, dude.
I don't know. Kevin Nash trying to get paid, though.
True, true.
Power bomb. I almost typed power bomb ski. Oh, Canadian destroyer.
Power bomb ski.
Puerto Rican destroyer. Is that it? Ooh.
Power bomb ski.
Yeah. Oh, here we go, Falcon Arrow.
You know what I actually just recently watched?
What's that?
Kevin Nash vs. Goldberg, WCW title.
With the cattle prod from Scott Hall?
Yeah, yeah. People were going crazy.
Yeah.
Ooh, I can't find this right now.
Bad Bunny is nasty, dude. You know what I want to see, and I'm so excited because they have to eventually do it. Bad Bunny versus Logan Paul.
You think, right?
They got to. Because they're both kind of nasty.
Here we go.
Here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Nah.
Whoa. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Iron Man match though, 1-1.
If Big Kev loses this, he's probably gonna hold you up for like 100K.
Well, I mean that's when he'll send him over your
way. He's tough to deal with, bud.
Another one. Here we go. Puerto Rican destroyer.
He's tough to deal with.
Puerto Rico, se me gusta. Let's go. Come on. 1, 2. Is another 3? Wow, that's 2 for Bad Bun.
Big Kev's gonna be upset.
Yeah, he is. He's definitely not selling this Nitro.
He's going to be very mad.
Uh-oh. Hit smash. But also, there's 6 minutes left.
Get a couple jackknives in there.
Couple jackknives.
You know what's weird? Is like, moves get recycled, right? So like, a lot of people have similar moves, stuff like that. Have you seen anyone else besides Lex Luger use the torture rack?
Kind of, but not really. When I say kind of, I mean like Abyss, because Abyss would do shock treatment.
Was it torture rack, though?
Yeah, he would torture rack you and then fall to his butt, so you would...
Oh, yep, boom. Yep.
And so I did it one time, because he was there, and then I was like, I'm never doing that again.
Why?
That hurts. Is Bad Bunny gonna cut it out?
You gave the move.
Gave it to somebody. And I was like, all of my discs are gonna shatter.
Yeah, yeah, there was a guy on the indies that broke his neck doing it.
Yeah, that's not a, if you, and also Sue, so like Abyss is way bigger than I am.
Monstrous, yes.
It's very different. Also, I think, and let's talk about this, Abyss, one of the best big men to ever wrestle.
That's a big statement.
Bro, I loved watching him wrestle.
Really? I haven't seen a lot of Abyss.
You haven't?
No.
Bro, I can't remember what the pay-per-view is called, but it's one of the pay-per-views where Every single match is the cage match. Mm. Like every, like just like we book, mm-hmm. where they book every single match is a cage match. And it was AJ versus Abyss. And so there'd been like a couple matches already. So AJ and Abyss come out. And before AJ can get into the cage or Abyss gets in the cage, AJ dives out and jumps on him, boom, boom, boom. Abyss throws him off of him. And AJ baseball slides underneath the guardrail where the fans are and then springboards off the guardrail and pops Abyss in the face and they keep brawling. But like the way that they're doing it and the way that Abyss is moving around, like it is incredible and really? So just so good. Kevin Nash about to go up. He's got a three and hit him with a jackknife.
He's getting another one.
Yeah, he said, Bad Bunny, you can't do this to me.
Give me that J-knife, dude.
I was in WCW. You know how much money I was making?
Yep.
A week in WCW? A
little C-slam.
Boom. I'm about to pin you again. Yeah. Let me get this another three.
Oh, my God. He's stacking them.
One, two, three. He's like, let me hit another jackknife because I got it on me.
Bad Bun's hurting
me. I got
it
on me.
Oh, God.
I told you. Bro. He said, this is no. Oh, running. Oh, running. He ran with it. Three. Bro, that's no way. I've never seen him run.
Never.
Oh, he said, I don't care what you do to me, Bad Bunny.
He said, I'm up by like five now. You do whatever you want in the next 3 minutes.
I wish they had the score. What if Bad Bunny comes back?
There's no way.
I don't know if he puts him through the announce table, maybe.
Maybe. Determined to get those stairs, though.
No.
You're not getting
Bad
them,
Bunny.
Dude.
No. No, not on the stairs. Oh, ooh, arm drag. Ooh. Here we go. Ooh, he's got a
lucha.
150 seconds.
He's got that lucha.
Oh, this is not good for Bad Bunny.
Bad Bun.
Bro, what did he do? Jackknife, chokeslam, jackknife?
Yeah.
Jackknife, chokeslam, running jackknife. Yeah. Bro, what? Why does he have a running jackknife? That's so nasty. Here we go. German suplex. Nope. Shot to the back. Spin him around.
Nah.
Here we go. What you got? Poison. Nope. Regular. Into a pin. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Bad Bunny with two minutes left. Look at three. There's three. Oh, Bad Bunny fighting.
Bad Bunny could come back.
Bro, I love
time.
A night
lot time. Of time.
Night time. The backhand, the disrespect. He said it's 2032, baby. I will tell you, the past 6 months, I've been listening to a lot more Bad Bunny.
Really?
Bro, dude is nasty.
I think I've heard some.
You gotta listen to it. Here we go. Boom, drop kick to the head. He's gonna pin off this. Nope. Pick him up. He wants the drama.
He's got more.
Finish. Lung blower. Did he hit it or did he reverse it?
I think he hit it, but he's tired.
Oh.
He hit it, but he's like super tired.
Moonsault to the pin. Pin.
No,
off the top. Off the top. Can he tie it back up? Here we go. Bad Bunny with the elbow drop in the pin. Pin him, dude.
Oh, my God.
Oh, charge finish. He is fighting. He's
down right now, right?
He is. He's down. Is he stealing a jackknife? No.
Oh.
Puerto Rican Destroyer. Oh, Kevin Nash. If he bent like that, his back would break.
Yeah, oh, yeah. He took like four moves in a row.
Can he get another one? Can Bad Bunny get another one?
I swear he's still down.
I think he's down by one. All you gotta do is tie it, dude. Boom. Get him in the ring. Bunny, quit taunting. You have 30 seconds.
This is where the inexperience comes in. Big Kev ain't gonna make that mistake.
Too much of an entertainer.
It's true.
Mm-hmm.
Big Kev's like, you know what? I'm just gonna ride this out.
Yeah, Big
I'm
Kev.
I'm just gonna ride this out. This is how it's done.
Bro, can I tell you the story?
What you got?
So we're I was at the movies when I was a kid. I saw Kevin Nash getting popcorn. And
is this like prime WCW Kevin Nash?
Oh, it's so hot in Atlanta. Powerbomb on the ground. Nope, he's getting in the ring. Kevin Nash is up by one, I think. Obviously winner Kevin Nash. I run up to him. He's doing something. He's busy. He's buying popcorn.
He's by himself getting popcorn.
Yeah, buying drinks, whatever. And I run up to him, and I'm all of, like, child age.
Sure.
Kevin Nash, oh, this is so cool. Oh, can I get your autograph? And he goes, yeah. Come with, just follow me. And so he has all his stuff, and his hands are full, right, when I'm asking him this. He walks into the movie theater, or he's walking towards the movie theater. He goes, yeah, just wait here, and I'll be back. And he goes into
the
theater.
He never came back, did he?
Bro, I waited for so long.
Oh, that's great.
And I was like, he's gonna watch this movie, bro. Yeah. Of course.
Hey, I'll be right back. Stay here, bud.
So I left, and then later in life, when I like became friends with him, I was like, honestly, like now, like that's very funny to me.
Yeah.
That is, it's like hilarious to
me. Ridiculous. Wait right here. I'll be right back.
And like knowing him, I'm like, oh, that's a very Kevin Nash.
Ridiculous.
Bad Bunny Kevin Nash.
Bad Bunny Kev.
There we go. There we go.
A little card ski on that, Iron Man?
I think so. Yeah.
Had to be. Bro, had to be. No rivalry?
I freaking love Kevin Nash, dude.
Watch that match back when he beats Goldberg.
Yeah.
Great
match. And a rivalry.
Great match.
Bad Bunny Kevin Nash about to be hot. 4-5. Flint McStone's in there with a weak promo. That's okay.
Weak ski, 1500.
Upper body business. He's jacked up top where it
triple
counts.
Triple threat, puts hell in a cell.
Almost hit simulate. Here we go. About to get it.
Spectate. Title on the line?
Title on the line.
Title on the line. Hell in a cell card on this thing.
Mm-hmm. Wow. GG has a chance to be tag champ and women's champ.
Don't like it.
St. Louis, Missouri with the MO. Yeah, so living in Atlanta, or I was living in Marietta, 20 minutes, 15 minutes from Atlanta. WCW was, it was like religion, dude.
Wow.
It was wild.
Everybody was so good. WCW was hot.
Bro, seeing like Yuji Nagata somewhere, you're out getting a burger with your family and you're like,
Yep.
And then, so I got to go to New Japan and wrestle for like the hottest of seconds. And I met him, I met Yuji Nagata, and I was like, bro, I would see you around, and like, I'd lose my mind. We'd take a picture together, and I was like, this is friggin' awesome!
Yeah.
Do you have a favorite Japanese wrestler?
Like of all time?
Yeah, not to be of all time, like your favorite right now, if we're having this conversation.
You know who I've always thought was very cool was Mara Fuji.
Yeah.
I just thought he was like very creative, and when I was working with Kenta all the time, I watched a lot of their stuff to like learn about Kenta.
Yeah.
And my God, dude, like.
So sick.
Oh, on YouTube, there's like highlight videos of their crazy matches. And Kenta Marafuji is just nuts. Nuts. I asked Kenta, like, after I watched it, I said, why are you guys going, like, you guys are taking these crazy bumps on the floor and, like, everything else. He goes, I don't know. And I went, like, why? Why are you guys doing this? And he went, oh, yeah, that one hurt really bad, and so did this one. And I was like, my God, you guys did not need to do this. But they had such a crazy, crazy rivalry, man.
Did you do any special like research when you were gonna work Liger?
I watched a lot of his stuff. So like same thing I did with Kenta. When I knew that Kenta was coming over and I was gonna work him, I just looked up like everything I could on YouTube. Like went down a Kenta rabbit hole, and then like okay, hey, you're gonna work. So then I had like a million ideas for all of his stuff, and then it was just like okay, cool. And then same thing with Liger. I kind of like looked up his stuff and then was like all right. Stuff that he does now, stuff that he's done before, stuff that he hasn't done in a long time. Thought of like a million just ideas and suggestions and like, hey man, maybe you like this, maybe you like this, maybe you like this, maybe you like this. But I wanted to know like all the stuff that they did basically.
Yeah. That's so sick. I feel like that's always such a, I don't know, like it's such an important thing in wrestling history that you worked Liger.
Kind of, yeah.
It's like really, really important.
Sometimes it doesn't sound real.
Yeah, right.
Like, because it's like, okay, there's like several things to it. Like, one, he only ever had one WWE match.
One, and it was against you.
Like, why did he, like, he only had one in his entire, like, 30, 40 year career? And yeah, it was against me.
Wild.
It's pretty insane. You just think like he was such a star. I mean, I guess he worked WCW, but like he never just never really worked WWE, man.
Yeah, it's different. It's like, you know, so like when Sting came over, and what, Sting, what, worked Seth?
Yeah, yep.
Did he work any other matches? I remember.
I think he worked Hunter.
Okay.
He worked Hunter at Mania, and then DX and NWO came out.
Oh, yeah.
But I think that might different. Be it. That was a Mania. That was a Mania match.
Yeah, that's even so different than you working with Liger. Like, it's... I don't know. That's a cool moment for me to think about, like, that you got to have, because it's such an iconic performer
in
what we do. And, like, you're the guy who got the chance to... like to dance with him.
It's insane.
On an NXT show.
Yeah.
You know, so like it wasn't like what are we, what? Okay.
It was nuts.
That's really cool.
Yeah. I actually, when I found out about it, I thought they were joking. Cause I was like, I'm like, okay, like I've worked everybody here basically. So like what's next? And it's like, oh, you're gonna work with Liger. And I said, okay, well one, he doesn't work here. And two, like what a random like, you guys are clearly messing with me because that's just so random.
Yeah.
And then it's like, oh, no. Like, yeah, that's actually who you're working with. Like, one, how is this happening? And two, what the hell? Like, this is a thing? This is actually going down. Okay.
Bro, that's like another level of trust.
It's crazy.
Especially to have, like you said, to have somebody who doesn't work here.
Yeah.
That is so iconic in so many other places. And they go, okay, you're the representative that we are going to trust. We're going to trust you to take care of his body.
Yeah.
Like, what?
Yeah.
What's going on with Gigi's body right now? she okay?
Yeah, she looks a little out of it, bud.
I think she might be stuck. And they're just going to keep fighting over her dead body?
They'll fight on her dead body.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
She's turning. Is her hair stuck?
Is she...
What happened to her?
What did she take up there?
I don't know.
They're just all over her, trampling her.
I feel like she's fully out of the match.
I don't know. I feel it looks like her head is through the cage.
It really does.
She might get up at some point.
I really don't think, unless they mess with her.
They might have to like pick her up.
Which I don't think they're going to.
Jesus.
But this part of the cage is broken.
Yeah, that's true. I love that they're staying right next to her, though.
Yeah. All this area to be on.
You can go anywhere. But instead, you have to trample the other competitor.
Oh, this is what I want to talk about. Hey, so... you need to go to Vegas and see Usher perform.
Oh, yes. Please tell me about Usher.
Bro, it was the most incredible... is this Brainbuster happening? Oh, squat time. The most incredible concert that I've ever seen in my life.
That's a gigantic statement.
It's huge. And I'm well aware how huge it is. I have seen so many concerts live. I've seen musicals live. It is the best performance that I've ever seen on a stage.
And this isn't just a normal concert. This is like an Usher show at
in Vegas. So it's his Vegas residency.
Sure.
So I think at the point that this airs, I think he's gone right now, but he comes back in October. I'm going again. I'm going to go again
in October.
Yeah. So I'm trying to like do more stuff.
Sure.
So like definitely going again in October with some friends.
How does he sound live?
Bro, unreal. So you know how a lot of people at concerts, they'll just like lip sync their stuff?
Yep.
It's like,
yep.
Oh, you're here to see my dancers and my outfits. And
that's
like,
right.
It's a performance. Like, Usher's doing all that and singing.
Wow. And he sounds good.
He sounds great.
A lot of people, some people like in concerts, man, they sound like crap.
Yeah. No, he sounds very good. And I'll give, are you cool if I give one spoily?
Yeah, I mean, you know what you're getting when you go to an Usher concert.
Yeah, I feel like there's enough videos and stuff on the internets about it. So the stage, there's a stage, and there's like a pit for people to stand.
Yeah.
And then the stage kind of like comes out in a half circle in front, and it's like, oh, this is kind of cool. And then at one point, they all come out, and him and all his dancers have roller skates on.
Okay.
And they're all just like jam skating. So they're just dancing and skating at the same time. And he's singing while he's doing this. And it is freaking incredible.
Do they have like a, where was the, where was the actual like residency?
It's at the MGM Grand.
So do they got like a big, like a big stage and stuff?
Yeah, the stage is huge.
So and these, that's where they just roller skate around?
Yeah, so like it's, like I said, it's the stage, and then from the front of the stage, it juts out into a big half circle. So there's essentially a full circle for them to skate around in.
That's cool.
But it's wild. There's a DJ who goes off for like the first like hour and a half, and it's just playing music and like getting everybody hype. Oh, is that gonna wake Gigi up?
Nah, nope,
she Gigi's is. She still... is. Duck. Just.
She's... oh, hey! She's up.
They
got her.
Go.
They got her.
Like, I got you now.
That's great.
She
was saving her energy, yeah. Bro.
Dude, legit, like, it's so wild. And just, and you don't realize, so Usher's, he's been in the game for like 20 years.
Long time.
And so every song he sings, you're like, oh, I know this song. Oh, I know this one too.
What was your favorite song you played?
So I'm biased to There Goes My Baby.
Okay.
That song is unbelievable to me. And when he sings it, it's like butter, just like getting leaked into your ears, like melted. It is smooth. But also too, there is a part where he's singing and doing his thing, and you're looking at him, and the rest of the stage is blacked out.
Yeah.
And then when the lights turn on, there's like three like 30-foot stripper poles, and apparently flies in strippers from Atlanta to be a part of this show.
Okay.
And they are doing, it's not even like, oh, there's strippers here, this is crazy. It's like, no, these are like the most talented people that I've ever seen in my life on a pole.
Wow.
They're doing like the craziest tricks where it's like, this is art. This is performance at its finest.
Okay.
So you gotta go.
Did he play? Yeah.
Yeah, so at one point.
I mean, he's got to, right?
Yeah, we were standing up the whole time. And then when I heard the,
oh,
I didn't know it was going to affect me like that.
But that's
jumped out of my chair.
That effect has been happening since it came out, and it will always have that effect, I think.
Yeah.
Like, that is just, oh. Yeah, that's, I feel like, yeah, live would be badass, dude.
It was incredible. And so, you remember Bronson?
Yep.
So he told me that sometimes Lil Jon just randomly shows up.
Oh!
So I'm just praying.
That would be so cool, dude. Sometimes he just randomly shows up for the concert.
Yeah.
That'd be so cool. I actually just went down a YouTube rabbit hole a while back of like surprise people showing up at other people's concerts. There's some good ones out
Why?
There.
There Why was did a, this happen?
There was a Justin Timberlake concert, and Garth Brooks randomly showed up.
Oh, what
and
did he
they,
sing?
And they were on stage together singing.
And, what did they sing?
Friends in Low Places.
Oh, that's a good song.
And dude, so good. Like, what a combination. But you should hear the audio on it. The crowd is going nuts. Like, absolutely nuts. Like, they're already going crazy. It's Justin Timberlake, and then out comes Garth Brooks, and they're going, my God. Like, great.
Isn't Garth Brooks, he's like one of the highest selling concert people of all time, and like, his stuff's not on Spotify or anything like that. You have to buy his albums.
Yeah, he's in a category of his own.
So crazy.
He took concerts to another level. And I think he had a residency in Vegas, I think. I don't know if he does still, but he did for a while. But like, dude, there's like a different level when you go from like working arenas to like stadiums.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he's a, no matter what, from now until the end of time, he's a stadium guy. And he was a stadium guy for a long time.
That's so I'd be curious, because obviously, you know, like, Taylor Swift is going around right now.
Killing.
Like, murdering.
Yeah.
If, like, Garth Brooks and Taylor Swift went on tour together.
So this is, like, this is crazy to me. So I didn't understand, like, I mean, I get it, but. So Taylor Swift, massive superstar, obviously.
Yeah.
But, like, the debacle to try to get tickets was nuts. Like, people trying to get tickets, and then you had to get this code, and then you had to get approved, and then it was this thing, and blah, blah, blah. So if you finally got the tickets, then I heard that they were opening up the arena like a day or two before the concert so that you could go in and buy your Taylor Swift merch. Mm-hmm. So that like you didn't have to try to buy it during the show because basically
Oh, Oscar's down. Oh, Daddy's down.
Because basically you wouldn't be able to.
Yeah. So we were in
you have a whole arena. You have a whole arena rented for 2 days. Three days.
In Vegas. It may have been, was it for the Dell conference? The Dell Technologies conference? I think maybe it was another thing. But anyway, so we drove past the arena that Taylor was going to play in that weekend in Vegas. And it, like, they already had merch stands set up in the parking lot. And there were people camping out in the parking lot so that they could hit the merch stands before they get to the concert, because you just can't get merchandise during the concert because it's all sold.
It's so crazy, man.
It's wild.
So crazy. How do you get to that level of stardom?
I don't know, man. I don't think I would ever want that.
That's, yeah, you're like, you can't go anywhere.
No. Like, oh, here we go. Two parts broken in the cage. Sorry.
Yeah, that's it. It's pretty crazy.
Yeah. It's like not being able to go to the store, I feel like would be horrible. I enjoy like the level that we're at. Like, I wouldn't mind going up like one or two rungs. Like, If we were able to get like on a CW show,
sure,
play vampires and like run, be able to
sure.
Enough where we could run the GG's through. Enough where we could like make enough money for the rest of our lives running the convention circuits.
Oh, signings. Be like, great.
Let's be on Supergirl or something, you know.
Sure.
Let's be in like a Marvel movie and then we're good. Like something like that. Yep. I would never want to be in a situation where you like can't even go to the grocery store without getting mauled. It's like, That's gotta suck, dude.
Yeah, it'd be a little rough.
Because you can't live life.
No. You could not, like, just do random stuff.
Yeah. What if you want to go to a theme park with your friends and your family? Like,
not happening.
Oh, you gotta... Oh, Natty... Oh, she's almost went through. It seems like so much. And then, like, in that position, people want and expect so much from you. It's like, bro, I'm just trying to play Final Fantasy 16, dude. Like, I'm just trying to live.
That's right. So I want to be famous enough so that I can get a free code for Final Fantasy.
Yeah.
But, you know, also that's just it. Be able to get it and play it.
That's it. I want to be famous enough where I don't have to stand in any lines ever, but not famous enough to get mauled at the grocery store.
That's right.
That's like that's the best level.
That's great.
Oh, can I go to this football game front row and it's not weird for me to ask for these tickets and you give them to me?
Yep.
Dope. But I can't go to Whitewater and ride on this ride and hang out with my friends. Oh! Gigi's through again. Is Oscar going to pin her? Is Oscar going to pin her?
She's got a pinner. She's got a pinner. Natty's got to break it up.
Natty's coming through.
She's going to.
No, Natty, no. Let it end.
It'll never end, bud.
No, it is. So we've been in this match at least 20 minutes.
Yes.
11:40 last I checked.
The Hell in the Cells, man. The Hell in the Cells and a triple threat. Whew.
I was watching the Randy interview that he did with Barstool Sports with that guy, the Caleb guy.
Oh, funny one. Sunday, yeah. Dude, great.
He said, hey, you've had a lot of success in Hell in the Cells, so what advice would you give to those who were incarcerated? He said, wait, hold on, what?
I love those little interviews. Like, he has some that just fly off the rails, and they're hilarious, man.
Yes. Dude, have you seen the one with T-Pain?
No.
It is... I'm not even going to ruin it. Just watch it when we get done. It's so funny. And T-Pain makes maybe, like, one of the greatest points I've ever heard someone make.
Oh, I got to watch it. There was the funniest one that I've seen so far was, like a golfer, I think.
Is Natty gonna tap? Is Natty gonna tap to Gigi?
She's got two.
She's tapping! Gigi's double champ!
Tag champ and women's champ?
Yes!
Wow. Blessing and a curse. Blessing and a curse.
Uh-oh. Yeah, we're gonna need to fix that, so.
Yeah. Dub champ, dude.
Congrats.
Good for popularity, bad for booking.
Natty held it for so long with no defenses for a good long time.
Yep.
Rivalry goes Dolan. Oh, there we go. Five star.
Damn.
Yeah, but I did have a 2.5, so you're okay. What? Dolan, Oscar?
A little scattered all over the place here. PPV in the books. That means we also get shake-up cards, right?
Oh, it does.
Oh, my
no.
God.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Big results, shake-ups. Big shake-ups.
Okay, you had more overall because I had the 2.5, I think. But I had a 5.
Yeah.
For the main.
Yeah.
And new champion.
Openers tied. You had the edge. I had the edge. Bro, we were tied.
My mid-card.
You had the edge.
My mid-card was ass.
Okay. So my rivalry's complete there. Okay.
Okay. Yep.
Nothing there.
Level one.
Okay.
None.
Nothing. Yep. And complete. Cool.
Okay. We said complete there. Yep, wrote that down. Vinny McIntyre, level one. That's on level one. Kombucha is up for 2 weeks.
Kombucha, dude.
4-5. That's a level one. And level two. Okay. Continue.
Let's take a little peek ski here.
Oh, man.
177.
Ooh. Ouch, losing money.
How do you lose money?
That boring sellout promo by Club Arella tonight. Ouch.
Wow. Okay.
Dang.
Okay.
You need to see your Twitter stuff?
Nothing that stands out. 177. Lost that mon. Okay, I'm good.
Ready?
Yep.
Okay. There you go. Good.
I see it.
Ooh!
230?
Ooh!
How the hell did you get 230?
Ooh! Drew McIntyre's with natural steel cage matches? There we go.
Did you get the 230 from the 5-star?
I mean, I don't know. I mean, we're just out here booking. We're just out here booking.
You know? Hold on, go back.
I can't go back.
Yes, you can. It says right there, back.
Back? What you want to see? What you want to see? Huh? What you trying to see?
Interesting.
What you trying to see, baby boy? What you trying to see?
Okay, go forward.
I can't even describe tonight's hashtag WCW. Absolutely amazing.
Interesting.
Wow. Flame and Steiner work really get well together as a tag team. Man. Finn defends a title. Dana Brooke trying to lay down the law to Bayley in that promo, but it kind of sucked. Ouchies. Nash was killing. Tonight's WCW is better than last week. You ready?
I'm ready.
What do you think it's going to be?
230. I should still be ahead, I think.
I think I might be ahead by a little bit. Oh, revenue tier one. WCW earned $2 million. You probably hit that already, didn't you?
I don't know.
You hit that. I think you did. Because you have a couple, and I don't have any. Ooh,
well, I just hit it now. Tier.
Oh, wow.
We both just hit it together.
Hey, look at that. Dang. Ooh. I'm nipping at the heels.
We're close.
You didn't even use Shelton. Why didn't you use Shelton?
Because you know why. You know why, you jerk.
Why, though?
All right. Shake up.
Okay. Ready?
Yeah. I don't know who's first.
I have to look. Oh, no shake up.
Oh, I think it comes after your emails.
Oh, so do we need to film this?
Yeah, keep it rolling.
Okay, contract is up at the end of the week. What you want, Giovanni?
Giovanni, dude.
65?
How about that? 45?
You know what? No. I'll
they've gotten smart about it. They've gotten smart about the, if you offer them the lower, they just straight up say no now.
Yeah.
They're like, nah.
My contract is up at the end of the week.
Big book.
Well, how much do you want, though? 64.
How about that 44 book?
Yeah, how about that 44? It'll be fine. I was looking forward, but I'll see you next week. I know you will.
Okay, he's okay with it. You will. He's okay with it.
It's been too long, but I'm back. She was filming a movie.
Oh, that's right.
Thanks for the opportunity. The movie was getting some serious buzz during the screenings. This is great for my career. Great to have you back. We need you here. Great to have you back, baby girl. Let's get back to work. Becky Lynch said, I'm coming for the title, Juju. I'm not happy losing my strap last week. it's not a belt. A belt hangs up your pants. As a former champion, I'm acting my rematch clause. I want a championship match against Dolan. Nobody better else get a shot at the WCW Women's Championship before me.
Yikes.
Seems reasonable.
Okay, okay.
Okay. Cool. Cool, 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 cool. Don't get me waiting too long. I already missed wearing that gold around my waist. First off, don't give me that first part of that sentence. Don't get me waiting too long. First off, don't speak to me like that. I'm your boss. We have a specific boss employer. Well, we have a specific boss independent contractor relationship. So you can technically do what you want by the lay of the law. But since I'm your boss, I'm going to get mad if you do. So don't do that. Okay, moving on. Listen, I'm not feeling physically 100% right now. I don't mind pain. But I don't want an injury.
Oh, she wants that time off.
Take some time off. I was going to take some rest. Thanks, boss. I appreciate you, Oscar.
I'm not going to look if this pops up.
Okay. You better not look.
I'm not looking. Press
it. Ooh, shake up. Shake up.
Yep.
Okay. Okay. These are all very good.
I don't like that. I don't want any of that.
I don't want that one, but these two are. So if you're watching, which you are, that's why you see this. This one is golden. That's good. This one, also good. That's only gonna be a thing and sort of
can only pick one, dude. Can only pick one.
Okay. Okay, well, I think we're gonna go this one. We're gonna go this one because we need to do certain things, so we're going there. Boom.
Got it?
My word. That is unbelievable.
I don't like that.
You shouldn't like that. What I just got is honestly a big problem for you.
Come on.
I'm going to be perfectly honest with you. What I just received, the blessing that I was just given from the heavens above, the blessing that the universe just brought to me and allowed me to receive, is not good for you.
I don't like it.
Good.
I don't like it.
Good. I mean, I know. Okay. So that's the end.
That's it. PPV so we'll in the book. This... Extreme Rules. Done. Now we're up to week 16, bud.
Okay, so Breezy, still in the lead. How you feeling?
I feel good.
James Brown good?
Yeah, I mean, all right.
Yeah.
You know? Good little PPV. I'm a little confused as to why you had more than me.
More what?
More fans.
Well, because I was killing.
But you had a 2.5 on the show.
In the mid card, people were going to the bathroom anyway.
So the fiver at the end made that much of a difference?
Yeah. And I don't remember if I did play keep my fans card, but I may have.
What do you mean to keep my fans card?
Give me more fans card. I don't know. One of those cards.
Oh, maybe.
I may have. I don't remember. It's been like 3 weeks.
Interesting. Okay. Who knows at this point? Either way. Still ahead. 100,000.
Yeah, that's not a lot.
And we got to keep going here. We got to keep going. This is... Yeah. We're not even... we're about like a quarter of the way through, I think.
Yeah. Because they said that we're halfway through this season, which means we're a quarter of the way through our season.
There you go.
And if I'm being honest, things are looking very good for me.
Okay. I like the confidence. I like the confidence.
Yeah.
That's not bad.
It's really good.
It's not bad.
It's really good. I love a nighttime pay-per-view.
The ambiance, I got to say, the ambiance of the PPV at the nighttime.
Yeah.
I like it.
Yeah.
I like it.
So what conversation topics did we cover?
We covered Dawson's Creek.
Mm-hmm.
We covered Afros.
Mm-hmm.
Covered Lenny Kravitz.
Yes.
Kevin Nash.
Yeah.
WCW in Atlanta.
Oh,
A lot of stuff. A lot of stuff we covered.
Hell of a time.
Might be coming back. Knoxville, Tennessee.
But what's the
Saturday? NGW.
NGW.
NGW Saturday. I'm looking at the calendar. Today's Monday. It's the 4th. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. It's 5th, the 9th.
Hell yeah.
July 9th.
Hell yeah.
NGW title on the line.
Hell yeah. And you know what? I'm gonna be there.
That's ridiculous.
I'm gonna be there. All right, y'all. Thank you for watching this episode of GM Mode. We will be back, and we will film all this week up until what? SummerSlam was the next pay-per-view, I believe.
Oh yeah, 4 weeks to SummerSlam.
Yeah.
That's a big boy. That's a big
one.
Until
SummerSlam.
That's a big one.
Biggest party of the summer, some may say.
That's what they say.
Sweet. And maybe you know what? Maybe at SummerSlam we'll do nighttime audience again.
I'm okay with it.
I do like it a lot.
I'm okay with it.
It's nice. Real talk, real talk.
Real talk, real talk.
This like button thing. I know, like, it's the YouTube thing. Hit the like button, subscribe, hit the bell, notifications, all that good stuff. But legit, if you guys legit, our core audience, y'all, if you hit the like button, it will help us out in ways that you don't even understand. But most of you probably understand because this is YouTube and we all know how YouTube works. So please hit the like button. And also, you know what? I'm not afraid to say it. Let's go ahead and pad the numbers. Go to videos you haven't even watched and just hit the like button.
It's two clicks.
Yeah.
A couple little click, 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 click.
Yeah. When it says upcoming video, if it's up, up, down, down, just say yes and then just click like and then hit the X button.
He's not lying.
It's okay.
He's not lying.
It's okay. Why? Because it's gonna help us overall. That's and right. The more stuff that we get to do, because our videos have more likes on them and they go out to more people, then more people come in and they go, hey, here's money to do this dumb thing that you guys want to do, and then you guys get to see it. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. And make sure you're always and forever keep it tight.